Today, we introduce you to a classic credit scoring use case. The loan granting process usually requires some manual steps to evaluate parameters like the applicant assets, age, and credit history. Based on this evaluation, the bank clerk must decide whether or not the applicant is trustworthy. We want to replace our human clerk with a machine learning algorithm. In this case, we decided to use a random forest. We will train our model so that it can distinguish between the applicants that are worth a loan from those who are not. To do so, we implemented this workflow that reads the data from the German credit dataset file, renames the target class, splits it into two datasets, one for training and one for testing, trains a random forest model to predict whether the applicant is trustworthy or not, and then evaluates how well the model performs on the test set. We have also implemented a separate workflow that deploys the train model on new data. That is, it reads the train model and applies it to evaluate the new incoming loan applications day after day in everyday bank operations. Notice that the train model in the end produces the probability of the applicant being loan-worthy. Decisions about granting loans depend on how conservative we are at evaluating this probability. The higher the threshold applied to the probability, the more conservative the decision process. For the model performance evaluation, a confusion matrix is calculated on the data of the test set. The confusion matrix is a way of counting the number of correct predictions and the number of mistakes. However, not all mistakes are the same. We can associate a cost or a profit to each decision. In general, refusing a loan does not bring any loss. Granting a loan to a creditworthy customer brings an average profit of 0.35 euros per each euro borrowed, as it was estimated for that financial year. Granting a loan to a risky customer results in losing it all. We can then multiply the cost-profit values by the confusion matrix numbers. With this component view, users can pick a threshold and compute the related confusion matrix. The graph shows how changing the threshold affects profits.